Someone from 92.5/105, guys. Not to interrupt some Dave Matthews here. It's been a good show.
Feels a little sacrilegious, really, but it's cool.
It's all right. It's okay. And you know why it's okay?
Why is it okay,
Chris? Because today's the day, man.
It is the day. What day would that be?
You've got the block party coming at you 5 to 10 this evening. And we've got the Dave Matthews tribute band.
The, not just a Dave Matthews tribute band. We got the Dave Matthews tribute band.
Yes.
Which is insane. They are so good. If you close your eyes and listen, it's almost, it sounds weird to say, but it's almost better than seeing Dave Matthews now. Because, like, it sounds like Dave 20 years ago.
And they're playing, so that's the thing about this tribute band, is they're focused on the golden era of the DMB.
Yes.
That's where all the classics came from.
Oh, right, right, right. And they're so good at what they do.
And on top of all of that, it's way cheaper.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm not sure what it costs to get the original DMB lineup for the new band now together, but yeah, that's pretty unattainable.
Yeah.
And not to mention, if you go to get tickets, it's like $3,000 a piece.
For the crowd, it's way
exactly
cheaper.
And you can come down and check out an amazing group that does such a perfect job. And oh, how much does that cost, by the way? There's a
it rhymes with, it's free. I couldn't think
of
anything
free.
Else that rhymed with.
I had pee. That was, I wasn't going to say
that.
That's
what it was. It's pee. But you did. And here we are live on air. You're tuned in, guys.
Yeah.
Kicking off the mix in the 2 o'clock hour. Mr. Tim Greedy.
Mr. Quint.
Yeah. Here, making it happen. Real quick, before we head downtown. Now, the rest of the Watertown First crew is down there as we speak.
Yes.
They're bringing in all of the local vendors. They're closing off that public square block. This is where it all starts.
Oh, this is where it all starts. A huge thank you to the city for coming in and putting the barricades up. And all the safety measures and everything, I mean, they really do a bang-up job. And it's a whole crew down there working. And they do that because we ask and because this thing has become such a big deal over the last 10 years. How long has this been going on?
I think it's like 7 years or something.
Is it like 7 years now?
But it's been increasingly getting bigger and bigger.
Last year was record attendance. It was absolutely huge. I think we hit 7,000 total. I think we're going to blow right past that this year, based on just last month.
Yeah.
Such a big, fun time. And this is an even bigger gig, so I mean,
I would say so. And you know, when it's not, of course, we got DMB spinning in the background. We've got the tribute band closing out this evening from 8 to 10 or so. But we've got local legend Brittany King
from Watertown
opening up the show. And, you know, everybody knows him.
Oh, yeah.
You've seen him.
Everybody in the North knows.
Such a voice, though.
Oh, yeah.
Like an
such
angel.
A beautiful voice.
Like an angel. And she's going to be opening up not only for the DMV, but also for one of her favorite bands.
And
soon
everybody's,
to be yours.
Yeah, soon to be your favorite band.
Cersei.
Ah, they are
from
so good.
Upstate New York. I got a chance to chat with Mel, who's the lead singer slash drummer slash keyboard player slash.
Slash. Slash.
Up.
Slash.
It goes up. And this is a duo. This is a duo. Husband and wife combination.
Mm-hmm.
Making beautiful music, connecting with the people. You should see how active their fan base is.
It's absolutely ludicrous. I really had a chance to get into them after you booked them, actually. Side throw out to Quinn's here. You did all the booking for these shows, man. I'm just calling you out. Well done, my friend. That's a lot of fans. But Cersei is such a dynamic band with like this huge beat. That whole drum thing she does, with sometimes they'll just call out and they'll do a thing and the band's, like the crowd's singing back. Thousands of people, it's just such a big sound and a big act for two people, so I cannot wait to see them.
Yeah, sounds like a full band. And
really does.
And they're just, it's a good energy.
Yeah.
It's a good energy, good people, great music. And they've been doing this and making a living off of music for 18 plus years, she said, which is rare.
That's a long time.
And they're an upstate New York based band.
Right.
And they've got the blueprint. You know what I mean?
Right.
As far as how it's done.
Right, right.
Just that sort of consistency, that sort of catalog as far as the music that they're going to be bringing. And they said they do covers, but really a lot of this stuff is their own.
Yeah. Yeah. There's plenty of originals in there. I think one way or the other, they just offer something for everybody.
Yeah.
So I think that's going to be a big hit. This is a block party debut, I believe.
Yes, absolutely.
This is the first time playing with us.
Absolutely.
So this is going to be a huge show, man. And on top of Brittany Keene and Cersei and the Dave Matthews Tribute Band, we have loads and loads of vendors. There's food and there's beers available not only from Watertown First at the big beer trailer right down there. That one goes direct to supporting the block parties and, well, basically helping us pay for this, because as you know, this is a free show, so we definitely have to come up with ways to keep it going. And on top of that, the local vendors there, I know Empire Square is going to be open, Spokes on the Square is going to be open. They've got tents and tables and all kinds of stuff out. So it's a great chance to shop local, support local. These are local vendors as well. All the vendors that we bring in tend to be right from within the area, because that's what we do.
Yeah.
And get down here. I mean, it's a crazy idea that you can come down and you can drink beer and you can help support the local economy at the same time.
Yeah, you don't have to bring your own beer. We've got the beer there.
Oh, we got the beer there for you.
And of course, all the businesses right there on Public Square are going to be wide open. They've got great deals as well for you all night long. That's food, that's drinks, alcoholic or not, man, whatever you guys are trying to get down with. But don't forget, this is an all ages event. They've got the Kids Zone.
Yep.
Off in the back, which was bumping last time. They've got bounce houses.
It was.
They've got face painting. They've got Pixlet with the video games on the side of the truck. How cool is that?
And I'm ready to make a little announcement that we're gonna have some guest stars showing up. The Zoo is back at the block party as well.
Awesome.
Time to plug the Zoo.
Okay.
The baby goats have grown a year that everybody lost their minds over last year, if you remember me walking around with baby goats. Well, they're a little bigger now, but they're going to be joining us back down at the block party today.
Awesome.
So meet the goats, pet the goats. It's awesome. They're San Clemente Island goats, so they're actually an endangered heritage breed of goat. So, and they're just the sweetest little freaking thing.
They're not the ones that like faint.
No, they don't faint. They don't let me around those. I would never get anything done.
Yeah, and your voice is too booming.
I would. I'd just, boom. Oh, I wouldn't need television anymore. Really.
Yeah, for sure. As far as entertainment goes, listen. So a petting zoo as well, guys. Things kick off at 5 p.m. going until 10. All ages, absolutely free. And I don't know what else you guys need to know.
I don't know. Well, we're gonna be there. So
naturally.
Want to hang out at the cool kids table, you know.
We can shout out Watertown Savings Bank, as well as Watertown Local Development Center Corporation, Watertown First, Tunes 92.5, who of course is a sponsor this month here, as well. Northern Credit Union, coming in a big way.
Friends at NCU.
And, let me see, Watertown. There's a list of individuals, man, that really come through behind the scenes and help make this happen and help get the word out there and connect all the dots. And whether you've been to one of these shows in the past year, or if this is going to be your first one, understand what it looks like and the size of it.
Yeah. There's an interesting thing that happens. Nobody that I've met so far in the years this has been going on, their first one was not their last one. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Once you come to one of these things, you tend to want to go to every single one. They're the biggest, most fun thing, I think, that I do all year. Is the block parties. I mean, this is the one. This is the key event.
Yeah.
The damn block parties, man. They're amazing.
It's in Watertown is becoming more and more known for.
Yes.
We have artists that have come from other places to perform or just to attend and say, we haven't seen anything like this.
Yeah.
As far as how well the community is connected together.
It's absolutely incredible and heartwarming. I remember that picture of Eddie Cito last time from behind. Was that you that got that?
Yeah.
That was your picture?
Yeah.
I saw that thing. I, like, from the ground, you don't know, and when you're putting the nuts and bolts together and trying to organize the whole thing, but then you see that picture, and you're like, oh my God, we did that. That happened. That happened, and it worked, and it was fun, and it's safe. That's another huge thing to point out here. This is a big, safe event.
Security's there, but you're right. You know, these are memories that you can't take away.
Oh, I agree.
And that will exist in the continuum of what Watertown was and what it is now and where it's going to be.
Yeah.
And then my man signing autographs on the side after that, just surrounded by, you know,
what a rock star.
Yeah, I'm telling
you. Oh, he really does. We got to get him. That was not his last show. There's no way.
No. But look, local legends here in the area to bringing in bands like Cersei and Dave Matthews Tribute Band, and of course more for August, but guys, right now it's about tonight.
It's
going down, kicking
this is party off, night
5 p.m. be there early. Oh, by the way, Laura Jane, local legend from Hollow and Steel.
Oh yeah,
sounds like Celine Dion, no joke. It's going to be performing the national anthem. housekeeping things are
really now
very special.
No kidding.
She and her husband are Fort Trump based. Her and her band, her and her brother.
This is me here to finish. Oddly enough, this is usually like, I don't know why I look forward to the national anthem so much. Yeah. Like, if it's because we always tend to wind up nailing it. It's a hard song. It's an easy song to mess up. If anybody remembers Roseanne Barr back in the 90s, you can do a big bit of damage to yourself if you don't do too good. But every year, consistently, we always have a great kickoff to every single one. There have been no real sour notes yet.
No sour notes yet. But also, we are a very mixed community.
We are.
Military and civilian and all working together.
And there's so much talent here as well, which is mind-blowing.
Guys, look, we might as well get to more music.
We should probably go park those.
We got to get out there. But guys, be down with that. I'm going to spend some tunes, relax, kick back, and hopefully we'll see you 5 to 10. Block party, bring a friend, bring a fam.
Bring a friend, bring the whole family, bring a friend's friend, tell your friend to bring a friend.
That's what it is. It's the weekend, and this is how we kick it off here. All the tunes with this, Tim, I appreciate you.
Appreciate you, bud.
Guys, on the way, tunes 92.5, 104.5.